It's 96 hours even. 96 even and coming up on 40 seconds. Ready, mark it. Okay, 96.01. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. 96.01. Good. Okay, stand by for more thruster fire in here. Circus. We got a fuel cell and purge in progress and trying to set up cameras and brackets and watching auto maneuver and Normal, normal. Another master alarm coming. Stand by for master alarm. Yeah, where's the voice tape recording? Okay. Oh, you son of a bitch, you. You know, all this food and stuff up here, you gonna take with you or drink or eat? Okay. Go ahead and grab me, want any of that? Yeah, I hate to bother you. Could you get my solo book out of R1 there? My solo book out of R1? Yeah, it should be another one. Big frappin' book with a bunch of updates on the cover. Thank you, that's it. Appreciate it.
This is Apollo Control at 96 hours, 19 minutes. We are now less than 1 minute to reacquiring the spacecraft on the 11th revolution of the moon. Flight Director Gene Kranz, since taking over the shift, has gone around the room, reviewed the situation with all of his flight controllers. We expect that when we reacquire, Buzz Aldrin will be in the LEM, beginning the LEM power up and checkout. He'll be joined in a short while by Neil Armstrong. We'll stand by now for acquisition of signal as the spacecraft comes around the corner.
Recall the highest rate you saw during this recent thruster activity? Did you say 4/10 or thereabouts? Do you recall the any kind of body rates that you saw during the thruster activity? Didn't you say something about 4/10? Maybe remember when the STS was acting up?
Network says we have acquired signal. We'll stand by for the call to the crew.
Houston, Columbia, over. Houston, this is Columbia, over.
Columbia, this is Houston, you read, over.
Houston, Columbia, reading you loud and clear, how may, over. Hey, Buzz, how about...
This is Houston, do you read, over?
Houston, Columbia, reading you loud and clear, how many?
Right, you're about three by, Mike, we got a lot of noise in the background, it's clearing up now. Break, Eagle, Houston, do you read, over?
Houston, Eagle, about 4x4, go ahead.
All right, you're just getting a voice check. Say the page you're on and you activate the checklist, over.
Roger, I'm on page 27, over.
Roger, understand, 27, we copy, out.
Columbia, this is Houston. Would you please give us two and accept? We have a state vector for you, over.
Stand by one.
Negative, Poon accept. You're about 3 by in the on the voice, Mike. Over.
Okay, you're coming in last clear, and I'm configured for normal voice. If you got any switch changes you want, let me know.
Roger, we got some noise somewhere in the system down here, I think. We're working on it. And I got a 130 landmark update for you and also a DAP load whenever you're ready to copy. Over.
Eagle is going to secondary transmitter receiver and secondary power amplifier, and I'll check with you in 60 seconds, over.
Roger, stand by. We're standing by, over.
Okay. Houston Eagle on secondary transmitter receiver and power amplifier, how do you read? Over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Over.
Right, 3Q5 by Buzz. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Out.
Roger, that's the same as 2-4. That's the primary.
Rod.
Houston Eagle back on primary, and I'm ready to proceed with the steerable antenna activation.
Roger, we're standing by, Buzz. Go ahead, over.
And I'll go to biomed dev right momentarily.
Roger.
LEM communications engineer reports that we're on the LEM steerable antenna, which apparently accounts for the quiet communications we're getting at this point.
Houston Eagle, got a very nice lock on the steerable antenna, and you should be receiving biomed right and PCMI, over.
Roger, Eagle, we got you five by. It's really beautiful. We got the high bit rate and the biomed out. Eagle, Houston, do you copy, over?
Roger, copy.
Okay, you got CMP on ARIG 5 and LMP on ARIG 7.
Houston Eagle, for your information, we're doing the glycol pump check now.
Roger, copy.
And there's the secondary glycol pump.
Roger.
And I'm on secondary, or number two pump right now. And I'll hold here for a couple of seconds and then switch back to number one.
All right, Jim. Columbia, Houston, over.
Houston.
Go ahead,
Houston.
Roger, Columbia. We noticed your DAP configuration. We'd like you to turn off B3 and C4, Mike, and for register 2 in the DAP, we'd like all ones, over.
C4 are both OFF on panel 8, and I understand you want, say again what you want to register to.
So Roger, in the DAP, we'd like you to load all ones, over.
Alright.
Columbia, Houston, did you hit the command reset around after LOS on the last pass, over?
That's affirmative. When we were having difficulty getting you, Charlie, here, I put the command reset to make sure I had control of the high gain.
Roger, thank you much. We're in good shape now. Over.
Okay.
Houston Eagle, can you tell me if you're picking up Biomed on the CDR now, over?
Stand by. Eagle, Houston, we're not getting any Biomed from the CDR now, over.
Roger, understand.
Eagle Houston, we got the Biomed on the commander now, over.
Very good, thank you. Houston Eagle, we're ready for an e-memory dump if you are, over.
Roger, we're ready, go. Eagle, this is Houston. We see the optics zero switch on. Before you take some marks, don't forget to cycle it back off and on, and then on, over.
Roger, Houston Eagle here. I wish we had one of those optics. I'll tell Mike about it.
Roger, Columbia, excuse me. Sorry about that.
This is Apollo Control. Armstrong is now in the lunar module, in Eagle, and the LEM activation and checkout appears to be going along very well, somewhat ahead of schedule. Thank you.
Eagle Houston, could you give us a heck on the time that you switched to LEM power and also verify that we're on glycol pump one, over.
This is Eagle, we're on pump one, standby for the switchover time.
Roger.
The switch time to LEM power is 95.54.00, over.
Roger, copy, Neil. Is Buzz back in the Columbia now, over?
Yes, he is.
Roger, thank you.
This is Apollo Control. We have about 33 minutes left in this pass before loss of signal. Neil Armstrong confirmed that the LEM power switch occurred at 95 hours 54 minutes, which would have put the put that activity about 30 minutes ahead of the flight plan schedule, and that appears to be about the pace that the crew is holding, that Armstrong and Aldrin are holding in getting the LEM activated and checked out. At this time, Buzz Aldrin has returned to the command and service module, where he'll be donning his pressure garment and then rejoin Armstrong in Eagle.
Columbia, this is Eagle on Simplex B. How do you read?
You're loud and clear on Simplex B, Neil.
Roger, read you loud and clear. Okay, would you configure for Simplex A, please?
Roger, going Simplex A.
Columbia Eagle, how do you read on VHF A?
Reading you loud and clear on A.
Roger, read you loud and clear. And I'm ready to get a time hack from you. Load the CSM time.
Okay. You want the TFM first?
Let's get your clock first, and then we'll get TFM.
Okay.
Give me a time to load.
97.01.30. Correction on that, Neil. 97.03.30.
Okay, I have 97.03.30 set in.
Okay, and you got about a minute to go.
Okay. Okay, let's do an 0665 on my mark. Did you get that, Mike?
Standing by for your mark.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, mark.
Okay, 9704.03.86.
Okay, I'm within 300. That's within our ability to keep together, I think.
Right.
Okay, now you want to give me CFM? Verbo 5, down 01, enter.
Okay, I got Verbo 5, down 01, enter, going 1706, enter.
Roger.
You ready to copy?
Go ahead.
Register 1, 5 balls. Register 2, 20017. Register 3, 20616, over.
Understand, R1, 5 zeros, R2, 20017, R3, 20616.
That's correct. And I'm standing by, configured to record your PCM data.
And I'm ready to start on a dock time use course align when you are, and when you're ready, go min dip and at hold.
Okay, stand by. for minimum dead band attitude home.
Okay, now I need your down 20.
Okay, I got Verbo 6 down 20. Give me a mark liner.
Okay, mark.
Register 1, plus 11202, plus 20741. Plus 00211, over.
Copy, 11202 20741 00211.
That's correct.
Eagle Houston, that course line looks good to us, over.
Roger. Okay, Mike, your attitude holds no longer required.
Thank you.
Okay, Mike. I'd like to copy a noun 20 again. 06, noun 20. Be on my mark.
Standing by for your mark.
3, 2, 1, stand by. Take it again.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, mark.
Okay, I read plus 11154 plus 207902 plus 00230. Over.
I get one. You get 11154 207902 00230.
That's correct.
Eagle Houston, I
okay,
have...
Okay, Houston, did you copy,
Eagle Houston, we have the angles. I'll read them back. Over. For the command module, 11154, 207902, 00230. For the LEM, 189-95, 02852, 35863. Over.
That's correct for Eagle and command module.
Roger.
You get the time was 97:14:20.
Roger, copy. Eagle out. Columbia and Eagle, LOS for both spacecraft 9732, AOS 9818. Houston out. We'll be right back. Eagle Houston, we have your gyro torque and angles if you're ready to copy over.
Roger, we're ready to copy.
Roger, Eagle, for X, minus 00060. Y, plus 00620. Z, plus 01080. Over.
Understand X, minus 00060. Y, plus 00620. Z, plus 01080.
Roger, Eagle, good read back out.
Houston, this is Eagle. You want us to go ahead and do a VERP 42 at this time?
Stand by. That's affirmative, Eagle. We'd like you to go ahead and final line, over.
Okay.
Houston Eagle, LMP, Eddie Reed, over.
Raj, bye bye, Buzz. How many, over?
Oh, loud and clear. I'm going to be going through an ascent battery check. You want to check my biomet briefly, over?
Roger, go ahead. Eagle, Houston, we got the good biomed on your Buzz, over.
Okay, let me know where it ought to be at this point.
Roger, you can stay there at that point. When we go LOS, we'd like you to go off on the biomed, over.
Roger.
You copy those angles, Houston, torque and angle?
Roger, they're correct. You can torque, over.
Apollo 11, Houston, we have about 4 minutes to LOS, at next AOS, 9818, over.
Eagle, roger.
Columbia, roger. Eagle, Columbia.
Columbia Eagle, go ahead.
Roger, the capture latches in the probe are engaged in the drogue. Would you like to check them from your side?
All right, stand by. Houston Eagle, ED battery A is 37.0 and battery B is 36.9, over.
Roger, copy both of those, buzz out. Eagle, Houston, we've looked at the e-memory, it's go, over.
Roger, e-memory, go. Mike, the capture latches look good.
Thank you.
Eagle, Houston, we'd like you to go to the Omni antenna, and next AOS, we'd like you to be in forward, over.
Roger, going to, which Omni do you want now, Ab?
Eagle, Houston, we'd like AF now and forward, it's AOS, over.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control. We've had loss of signal now. We'll next acquire the spacecraft in about 46 minutes at a ground elapsed time of 98 hours, 18 minutes. During that pass, Armstrong and Aldrin in the lunar module began checking out, activating the lunar module, and they appeared to finish about 30 minutes ahead of the scheduled time in the flight plan. They began early and maintained the pace. Both spacecraft looking very good at this time. And everything progressing very smoothly. On the next revolution, revolution 12, the crew will continue activation and checkout of lunar module systems. The following revolution, revolution 13, they will undock from the command and service module. At 97 hours, 33 minutes, this is Apollo Control.
Go ahead.
Roger, I'm getting ready to preload the probe. I'm going to disable all my roll thrusters. Would you please monitor my roll yaw?
Roger.
Go ahead. I got another verified capture latches engaged on my checklist. I've already preloaded the probe. It's sort of silly, so it's sort of your option whether you want to verify the engagement.
Okay, we got the hatch all latched up now, and we're getting ready for a pressure integrity check, so enjoy it.
Okay.
let us know how you're coming up there now and then.
I'm doing just fine. I've cocked 8 out of the 12 docking latches and everything is going nominally.
Okay.
All 12 docking latches are cocked.
Okay.
And I'm ready to button up the hatch.
Hey, Mike, have you got the got to the tunnel vent step yet?
I'm just coming to that. What can I do for you?
We're waiting on you.
Okay.
We're still ahead of the timeline, so
next time.
Okay, I'm ready to go to Limb Tunnel then.
Negative. It's a slow process. I'm on vent, but it's just going to take a little while here.
Okay, just give us a call. We're pressing on with some other stuff.
Okay. How's our attitude holding?
Looks good.
Okay, this thing's supposed to take about 8 minutes. We've got about three of them gone, so in about another 5 minutes, I should be able to turn my thrusters back on.
doing, Mike?
Doing just fine. The standby I'll give you the depth here. 3.0, I need 3.5 before I can bring my thrusters back on.
Okay.
I got 3.5 PSID now. I'm going to start a maneuver here in a few minutes to 3.2 after.
Okay.
starting to maneuver.
Thank you.
We're there. We're at the new altitude.
Okay, we're going to put our gear down.
This is Apollo Control at 98 hours, 16 minutes. We are now less than 2 minutes from reacquiring the spacecraft in its 12th revolution of the moon. At this time, Armstrong and Aldrin should be completing pressure checks on their spacesuits. Coming up in this revolution, they'll be running checks on the guidance platform of their LEM guidance system. They'll also be running checks on the reaction control system thrusters and their descent propulsion system, as well as the rendezvous radar. We'll also be giving them a go, no-go for undocking in the following revolution. The checkout and activation of the LEM up to this point has been moving along very smoothly. All systems performing well, and we were ahead of the flight plan at the end of the last revolution. We'll stand by now to reacquire the spacecraft. The LEM and CSM still docked, and Armstrong and Aldrin within the LEM, that will be their home for the next 30 hours or so. Now about 45 seconds from reacquiring. We're now about 15 seconds from reacquisition of Apollo 11, the spacecraft currently in an orbit with an apocynthian of 63.5 nautical miles, a paracynthian of 55.9. As we're continuing to see the apocynthian drop, the paracynthian raise, as the orbit becomes more and more circular. We should have acquisition of signal shortly. We will have some noise on the circuits until the LEM steerable and the CSM high-gain antennas are brought into play. Capcom Charlie Duke putting in a call to the crew. We'll continue to stand by.
unclear.
Yeah, I'm working on the high gain right now.
Charlie Duke asking the crew to verify in the LEM that they are on their forward on the antenna. We're still awaiting lockup and a stronger signal, and we'll continue to have noise on the circuit until we get a stronger signal. We do have telemetry data from the spacecraft at this time.
Copy. runway 33627. ASM white 36651. 6 trim 00470. Roll trim 00589, over.
Houston, the coordinates you have loaded in P-22 are, we have for site 130 prime. Do you concur? Over. Columbia, Houston. We made an error on those coordinates. We'd like you to load for latitude and the 989 plus 01243. Longitude over 2 plus 11844. Altitude minus 00146. It's shown in the flight plan. Over. Eagle, Houston, could you give us an idea of where you are in the activation? Over.
Roger, we're just sitting around waiting for something to do. We need a same vector, arrest map before we can proceed on with the ag. And we need you to watch our staff data load, cable drive check, and throttle test, over.
Roger, Eagle. We'll have the safe vectors and the rest map for you as soon as we get to high gain. Over. It'll be about another 10 minutes or so before we get through the P-22, and when we maneuver to attitude and get to high gain, we'll have the updates for you. Over.
Roger. We'll go ahead with the tap and the throttle check since we don't have a gimbal drive test, okay?
Roger, understand you're going to the DAP throttle. That's affirmative.
This is Apollo Control. We'll continue to have rather noisy communications from the spacecraft until the orbital navigation is completed. Mike Collins is preparing to take marks on a landmark near the prime landing site. This information will be received here in Mission Control and will be used to update the ground's knowledge of where the spacecraft is. and in turn that information will assist in setting the precise time for the powered descent. Once the orbital navigation is completed, we'll be able to get high-gain antenna and Lem steerable antenna locked on, and we should see some improvement in the communications.
Go ahead, Eagle, over.
Roger, in accordance with the Altair 47, step one, we have the guidance control and things and motion control things at all. And of course, the circuit breakers are not in on the thruster yet. So when we started through the damp and proceeded on down 46, and we're looking at down 47 now, where we got an ICS PCA light, and we've got four out of the eight rather bright colored red flags. I think that this is explained by the fact that we are in tanks and auto and just unable to fire the thruster over.
Roger, stand by. We haven't closed the breakers yet, over. Houston, we can see all the
throttle.
Go ahead, over.
Well, I can give you a high bit rate on the Omni-Nobel,
how many? Negative. We have all the throttle data we need. You can say low bit rate. You can proceed through the throttle test. Do not do the gimbal trim, over. Repeat, do not do the gimbal trim.
Roger, understand.
Well, you just can't miss those checkpoints with Diamondback and Sidewinder.
Houston, you can go ahead with the RTS pressurization, but we would like to hold on the RTS checkout until we get the high bid rate, over.
Roger.
And Eagle Houston, have you deployed the landing gear yet, over?
That's affirmative, the landing gear is out and great.
Roger.
Collins reporting that he has completed the marks for landmark tracking. We also got a report from the LEM that they have deployed the landing gear. Now that report came at 98 hours, 45 minutes.
copy, stand by on the 949, over.
Houston, if you go to react on a high gain, we can acquire you now, over.
Eagle, Houston, we got some loads for you if you'll give us two in data, over.
You've got two in data.
All right, we got both of you on the high gains now. It sounds great now, over. Columbia, Houston, I have a SEP pad if you're ready to copy, over.
Standby. Ready to copy.
Roger, Mike. SEP pad. RCS/GNN. Noun 47 and noun 48 are NA. Noun 33. 100 39er 5000. Noun 81 is NA. Roll 000 007 000. Rest of the pad is NA.
Hey, SEP RCS GNN had a TIG of 139.50. Roll 0, pitch 007, yaw 0.
Roger. Good read back.
Houston Eagle, are you ready for us to start the RCS checkout now?
As soon as we finish the uplink, stand by one, over.
Okay.
Houston, Columbia, comment on P-22, it worked just fine. The target I marked on is a small crater down inside. Crater 130 is described by John Young.
Roger, we copy. Eagle, Houston, on our load, during our load, we had to do a verb 96 to stop integration. We're going to start over again on this load, over.
Eagle, Roger. And Eagle here, I have read out address to the AG 404, 405, 406. And I had believed that 405 and 406 would both be all zeros. And I would propose maybe that I reset them to zero. I realize that 404 should be a negative number, and it is minus 13495, over.
Roger, copy. Eagle, Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Buzz, we got, the only thing we're missing here is the drift check. After we finish our load, we'd like you to do the drift check with Columbia, over.
Echo.
Eagle, Houston, the 404, 405, 406 look fine to us, over.
Roger, I'm going to be setting them to zero for the undocking. The question is, do you want me to reset 405 and 406 back to the numbers that they are now, or can I leave them zero? I intend to set 404 to minus 13495, over.
Stand by. Eagle, Houston, we would like you to zero, as called out in the timeline, all three addresses, 404, 405, 406, before undocking. After undocking, you can load them back to the values that you have right now, over.
Eagle, roger.